Hi, welcome to Turnitin Self-Directed, Part 2, the Similarity Report. This video will show you how to view your Similarity Report and use it as a proactive proofreading tool to improve your writing and avoid plagiarism. The Turnitin Similarity Report highlights matches between your writing and other sources. It is an interactive platform that allows you to compare the original source with your writing. Turnitin shows you possible instances of plagiarism, but it is up to you to assess each instance and decide which changes to make. In this video, I will talk about paraphrasing versus direct quotation, so it is important that you understand these terms. Quotation is when we use information from a source by copying it word for word and enclose it in quotation marks. Paraphrasing is when we reword a passage, usually a paragraph, in our own words and style, conveying the meaning of the original in a completely different way. This is where some students have difficulty in making their own words different enough from the source material. Writing is a complex skill that takes time and practice to develop. For more help with writing, visit the Tutoring and Academic Skills website. For help with citations or avoiding plagiarism, see the library website. Okay, I'm now going to log in to my account at turnitin.com. Now that I've logged in, I'm going to select Student Use and see if my Similarity Report is ready. It is ready. I see a 40% match there, but I'm not going to worry about that right now at all. I'm going to explore the report. So let's click View. This is called the Feedback Studio, and it is an interactive way of looking at the report. There are a couple of tools here that you can see by clicking the Layers button in the top right. The E-Rater is a grammar and spelling tool. We're not going to look at that today, so I'm just going to remove it from the report by deselecting it. Now I'm going to click on my percentage number in the red toolbar. So looking at this, I have a fairly high percentage, and I'm just going to start by taking a quick scroll down through my paper. And I noticed that my reference list has matched with a lot of sources, but that's not surprising, because if anyone else has used these sources, their APA citation should be pretty identical to mine. So it's not a plagiarism concern. I just want to remove those matches from my report. To do that, I can go to this filter icon, looks like a funnel, and it allows me to exclude bibliography. I could also choose to exclude direct quotes or matches that are less than a certain amount of words, but I'm not going to do that right now. Just going to exclude bibliography and apply changes. So I'm now down to a 26% match. Okay, let's start at the top and look at these matches. Number one is labeled here, and on the side in the match overview, I can see the source that it's matching to. And yes, I know from my own notes, I did use that source. But if I click on that source on the side, a little box pops up and I can actually compare directly the text from the site with my own. So this is actually very close to word for word. So even though I've included an in-text citation, it's a poor paraphrase and could still be considered plagiarism. So I'll plan to go back to my draft and rework this sentence. Okay, moving on. Under number two, I can see there's two large chunks there. The first one, American College of Allergy, Asthma, and Immunology, is the name of an institution. It has a lot of words in it, but it's not surprising that it's matching because anyone who's talking about this institution would have that phrase. So I don't need to worry about that one. Next, 10% of people are allergic to household pets. Let's click on the number two source just to compare the wording. And from comparing those two snippets, I can decide whether this is a generic sentence that doesn't need to be further paraphrased, or if I want to work with it some more to make it more unique. For match number three, I can see it's matching to the Live Science website, and that is the source that I used. A lot of those are very common phrases. I can see them scattered through the paragraph in the purple. But when I see that it sandwiches another source, I definitely just want to take a closer look. So I'm going to take a look at number four to see how close we are there. This is matching to not a website, but another paper from a student from some other college. I can't read the student's paper because their privacy is protected, but I personally know that I did not use this person's paper. So I need to dig a bit deeper to see why am I getting a match here. I can do that by clicking on the arrow on the right-hand side of this source and see the match breakdown. So I've got quite a number of papers there. But I also see my source as we get down to the bottom here a little bit. So I'm going to select that and see how close I am. Quite close, very similar. That needs to be changed. So I could either decide, do I want to just do a direct quote, or do I want to work on this paraphrase a bit to make it more unique? Let's go back to the match overview by clicking this arrow at the top. There we are. And we're now at match number five. This is my conclusion. It's a lighthearted way to end this paper. And I see I am matching with the site that I have used. So let's click that and see how close we are. It's not very close, but I probably want to get a bit more creative with this phrase and make sure that it is quite different. Okay, so now we have a list of edits that we're going to make to our draft, and that is great. However, what about the things that Turnitin doesn't flag? Remember, it's just a text matching software. It's not an artificial intelligence. So if I've paraphrased really well, it's not going to be able to match my source to anything. It's always a good idea, for many reasons, to do a proofread after you've taken a break from your work. So while you're waiting for your similarity report, don't look at the essay, don't think about it, take a walk, do something else, come back with fresh eyes to check your writing. So this first paragraph, it doesn't have any matches, but I do have a pretty specific piece of information about reward motivations for dogs, but I have included an in-text citation that matches the source I used. So that is correctly done. That was an effective paraphrase and I cited where the information is from. So let's move on. Here's another paragraph that didn't flag any matches in the similarity report, but it contains a very specific fact about dogs helping detect seizures. This is the type of fact that needs a citation to verify this information. So I'm going to have to go back to my notes and see where did I get that fact from. And then I'm going to have to insert an in-text citation and make sure that that source is at the end in my reference list. Okay, so that's a couple more changes there. Besides that, it's looking good. So once I've made those changes to my draft, I can decide to resubmit my paper to turn it in and check it again, or just hand it in to my instructor. So that's our look at the Turnitin Similarity Report. Remember, there is a manual on the library website under the Services menu, Academic Integrity Pages. You can also contact us at any time by using our Ask On Chat service or email library@flemingcollege.ca.